Namah Shivaya students, I hope you had a lovely puja, and so we are back now and we will be continuing with our Indian economy, and we will be doing this ninth chapter, which is environment and sustainable development. Now here basically, see, you have done such chapters in science in your previous classes when you were in smaller classes, and you have it now under the heading of environment and sustainable development. Basically, see, as you proceed with the chapter, you will be able to understand that what is the necessity or the significance of this chapter under the under economics, like why we are studying it under economics. Because basically, see, you have gone through there are many contents in the chapter which you have already gone through in your science classes, and so why is it been included in economics is something which you will understand as you proceed with the chapter. So we will start with environment and sustainable development. In this chapter you will be studying, like, you know, what we will do is we will be focusing on two things. First, we will be focusing on environment, that is the first thing, and the second thing that we are going to focus on is on the sustainable development. So basically, first, what we will try to understand, that is, we will try to understand in details, that is, what is environment, and then why it is it important, or what are the what is actually basically you understand by the concept of environment. So that is the first thing. The second thing which we will be focusing on is that what is sustainable development, that is, how it is also important. So that is what we are going to understand here, and we are also going to see to the effects of the environment, and also in a large scale we will be studying the different kinds of challenges that is being faced, environmental challenges faced in India, and then the different environmental issues. So that is all that we will be actually will be discussing in environment and sustainable development. Now coming to the very first term, which is called the environment. Now what do you understand by the term environment? See, we as individuals or as human beings, we have so many things around us. Okay, so like what we have trees, we have climate, we have water, we have soil, and so there are so many things which are surrounding us which actually affects us, that is, it affects our lives. So that anything, that is, all the conditions that is around you, and or you can say which is surrounding you, which affects your life, is termed as environment. So what we get is that environment is what? Environment is something which you are which is surrounding you, anything like which affects your life, whether it is sunlight, you say, whether it is air, whether it is water, whether it is fishes in the sea. So all these things affect your life. So these are called the environment. So anything which affects your life, which is surrounding you, is known as environment. So it can be, see, both. It can be living things also as well as non-living things also, which affects your life, right? And has an impact on your life. So that is what we call it as environment. So this is the basic definition of environment. Coming to the basic definition of environment, see, you have it here, that environment is defined as the total planetary inheritance and the totality of all resources. So it will include all kinds of resources, whether you say it. Now resources can be again of two types. One, see here, it is written abiotic resources, and another is your biotic elements you have. So abiotic resources, while all the living elements, that is birds, animals, plants, forests, fisheries, this will come under biotic, and like rocks, sunlight are all examples of abiotic elements. So what we find is that whether living or non-living, there are two kinds of elements which actually affects our life, and this is what we term it as environment. So this is what we call it as environment. Now having said that and having made the definition very clear, there is another important thing, that is, there is an Environment Protection Act which came out in 1986. Now according to that act, environment was defined as something which consisted of water, air and land. See, all these things are needed for our existence. We cannot stay without water, neither we can stay without air or land. Plus environment will also include human beings and other creatures. So there will be other changes as well. So this is total, in totality, this is what we call it as environment. So now every state, as per this act, what was made is that every state have to use these resources that are available in the environment optimally. That is, they cannot misuse the resources. They will be fully utilizing the resources and there will be no wastage of the resources. Now these resources are basically, you know, interconnected. For example, see, I told that environment will contain water, air, land, human being and other creatures. But here, see, human beings are interrelated. That is, they are connected with water. They cannot stay without water. They cannot stay without air. They cannot live without land. So these are all interconnected. So human beings are connected to all these components, whether air, water, land, etc., we are greatly influenced by the surrounding, or we are greatly influenced by the environment that we have around us. Now, having discussed the importance or the definition of environment, the next thing that we will be doing is the functions of the environment. Now, functions of the environment is also important. That is, what are the significance of environment, or what are the importance of environment? Why we say that, why we talk so much about environment? Why we say that we need to protect our environment? Because it keeps on affecting us. Now, how it is important in our lives, we will be discussing it point wise. Now, coming to the first point. Is see, environment offers resources for production. That is the main first point. That is, it offers production for it supplies resources which are required for production. So now see, when we talk about any economy, we say that the economy is growing. Now what do you understand when we say that, an economy is growing? That means it has increased its production. Now for producing certain goods, what you need natural resources, as in you need air, you need land, you need different kinds of other resources which are available. So now these natural resources are available to you from where? It is available to you from the environment itself. So we say that it is important. That is, for production purposes, environment offers resources for production. So for production, you get resources, or the natural resources that you get it from the environment. So environment is one big source of the production. It helps you in production. You know, when you have done this previous chapters in Indian economy, you have seen that during the colonial period, the Britishers, what they tried? They tried to make India a exporter of raw materials. Why? That means what? India has abundant of natural resources. That is, the surrounding environment had a lot. That is, the environment was in a position to produce a lot, have a lot of natural resources which could be used for production purposes. So that is the reason India was converted into an exporter of resources. That is, the raw materials, because India has it in abundance. So from this, it is very much clear the first point, that is, environment offers resources for production. So this is first. Now moving on to the second point, it says is that environment helps to it helps to assimilate waste. See, it is written here, it assimilates waste. Now waste, so now let us think. See, for example, what do you think? Like, for example, the industries is producing so many things. So what happens to this untreated waste of the industries? Basically, see, if you have a very clearly note, you will see that these big industries are mainly located in areas where there is a river nearby. Why? Because this untreated waste are being disposed in this places. Now this is something which I'm telling in a very larger scale. Now coming to a very smaller scale, let's take the case that is, every house has a kitchen. Okay, now the kitchen is a place where you are disposing a lot of waste also, because you are making things which you are consuming there. Now what happens to this, all the waste that is accumulated in the kitchen? What you do is that you go, and suppose if you go and dump it outside in a backyard, what happens is that after some days it becomes a compost, and after that a compost turns into a manure which could further be used. It becomes a natural manure. So that is waste that is generated from, for example, production. That is the example I've given you. That is the industry's waste. That is that production, during the process of production, waste is generated. And now, if you take the example of the kitchen that we are talking about in at home, it is an example of the consumption. That is the waste created when you are consuming something. So in both the cases, you find that is the waste that is created from production or from consumption is absorbed by environment. So what we find is that environment has one major role to play, that is it assimilates waste. So that is the second point. Now coming to the third point. Now what is the third point? The third point says that it sustains life by providing genetic and biodiversity. So what happens is that it will help you to, environment helps to sustain life. Now for example, say human beings, if they want to surviving, what they need air, water, as we have already discussed, also water, sunlight, soil, and these are present in the environment. So it is very important to have this in life. Okay, so for example, to live, you need all these essentials. So this environment helps you to sustain life, not only human life but any other organisms or the microorganisms, hence will be able to sustain life by the help of this environment. So this is another important thing. Again, you coming to the next one is environment. The fourth point, environment enhances the quality of life. That is, say for example, when you have a vacation, for vacation you go where? Suppose you go to the mountains, or you go to by the sea, or you go to a desert area. Now, why do we actually need to have such breaks? Why we go out? Why? Because we need a break from our mundane life. So that is the reason we go. Now, why this? Because the nature has a healing effect. It helps you to heal from inside. It helps to improve your quality of life. So once you are in midst of nature, you start feeling better. You start feeling positive. All the negative things goes out. So that is what is that healing effect is there in the environment. So that is again very important. That is, it enhances the aesthetic services like scenery, etc. It helps you to increase the quality of life. So this is another important function. So what happens is that, so the more environment you have, a good or protected environment, what happens is that it brings it positivity in your life. So that is all about the functions of the environment. So what I'll do is I'll keep it till here in this class, and then as we'll proceed forward with the chapter. So I will suggest that you go through it, and if you have any kind of doubt, just get it clarified. Om Namah Shivaya.